Hi, my name's Ernest, and I'm going to teach you how to cook. Today on Eating in Bed, some people reserve this night for Tuesdays, but tonight it is taco night. It should always be taco night. Now, I'm not going to show you how to make every bit of a taco, but I am going to show you how to skip that seasoning packet and make a wonderful ground turkey for your tacos that you would swear was authentic. In the extra helping, I'm going to show you how to make refried beans. They are so delicious, there's a couple of secret ingredients in it, and you're going to swear it's takeout from a genuine Mexican restaurant. It's taco night, y'all. Let's get going. I'm Ernest, and this is Eating in Bed. I think it kind of goes without saying that on Tuesdays, it's a particular kind of meal, but I love this thing so much, I will eat it any night of the week. In fact, I love Mexican food so much in general that I'm always scoping out the next really cool kind of local greasy spoon that makes great Mexican food. Tonight, it's not Tuesday, but it is taco night. Tacos have been around for ages and they are delicious, and there's a million ways to cook them. There's soft shell, there's hard shell. You can put just about anything in them and create something delicious. Now today the show's going to be really short because you know how to assemble a taco. Little lettuce, tomato, maybe some sour cream or salsa, or even your favorite hot sauce on it. You can put all kinds of stuff in a taco. Shrimp, fish, beef. Today though, I'm using ground turkey. It's a little bit lighter on the waistline and it's just as tasty. Now a lot of times when you buy the taco meals that you get in the store that come with tacos in them, they often come with a taco pack that of seasoning that is just absolutely horrid. It's filled with sodium. The shells are great, but the seasoning mix is really bad. So we're not going to use the seasoning packet. I'm going to show you in this episode how to make just really great ground meat for your tacos. So let's get started. The first thing we want to do is put a little olive oil in our pan, as always. Always start with the basics, just a little bit around the pan, not too much this time around. You want to get your oil kind of rippling, but not burning just yet. Just before it starts smoking, that's when you want to put your ground meat or ground turkey in. Now, the first thing I'm going to put in before I get started is onion and garlic. Onion and garlic has just become universal. It's in Italian culture, it's in Spanish culture, it's in so many different types of foods. So I've already started with one medium onion. Well diced. Doesn't that look great? Now obviously since you're doing tacos, you can use a Spanish onion. I'm using a good old white onion here. Just give that a little go around the pan. Don't go too hot. You want to pull your heat down at this point to a good medium, maybe just above medium. And to this, I'm going to add a little bit of house mix. House mix is really great to have on hand and use it anytime. You can marinate with it. You can put it in stuff while you're cooking. If you don't have any house mix, just a little bit of salt and pepper should do. About a teaspoon of salt, half a teaspoon of fresh ground black pepper. You want to put salt on your onions because onions are mostly water, and the salt will help bring out the water in those and help it release its water and cook down a little bit. Now we're not caramelizing them or anything like that, but we do want them to get really nice and soft and translucent. As they cook, they'll start to sweeten up a little bit and they'll just become delicious and wonderful. And who doesn't want delicious and wonderful, right? While this is cooking, a couple of other things that you're going to need are two cloves of garlic, finely diced. Remember, the best way to peel garlic is just to put the garlic underneath your knife and with the heel of your hand, hit your knife, and it breaks the garlic, the skin comes right off. You can snip that one little root end off and then just dice it really finely. But you don't want to put it in yet. Garlic burns very easily, so you want to put it in near the end of everything. The other thing you're going to need is a half a cup of corn. I use frozen corn because it tends to taste a little fresher than something out of a can. Of course, if it's summertime and you can get corn straight off of the cob, do that. Now, corn is an interesting ingredient to put in the meat. You would think that you would just make up some confetti corn or something like that and put it on top. But when you work it into the meat tends to be very savory, of course. And the corn has that great natural sweetness to it. So as you cook that into the meat, there's this wonderful balance of sweet and savory in your meat that is just fantastic. And it just tastes good. You're putting tacos on a corn shell. So it really brings out that corn flavor as well. Now we're gonna put a few spices in here eventually. You're gonna wanna get some chili powder, some cumin, and some smoked paprika if you have it. If you don't have smoked paprika, you can use regular paprika, but I love the smell and the flavor of smoked paprika. If you've never had it, ask your grocer where it's at and get some. The first time you smell it, you're gonna know why I'm bragging about it so much. So my onions have cooked down here a bit. So I'm going to go ahead and just make a space kind of in the middle of the pan here. Still not going to add the garlic just yet. I'm going to do that near the end of the meat. I've got about 1.3 pounds of turkey, and I'm going to break that up with my hands. Just put it straight in the skillet. And you want to just immediately start breaking that up with your spoon. If you have a spatula, you can do that too. Work some of the onion back into it. This is going to pull up some of the oil that was in the pan, and you don't want your meat sticking. Especially I'm using just a stainless steel pan here. If you have a nonstick pan, that's even better. If you feel you need to add a little bit of extra oil to your pan, you can do so about a teaspoon at a time. You don't want to over oil the meat or anything. But if you feel that the pan's getting a little dry and your meat might be sticking, or you know the ground turkey isn't quite doing what it's supposed to do, you can add a little bit of oil back into it, but not much. Go very lightly on that. I've seen some people add a pat of butter, and I don't think there's anything wrong with adding a pat of butter here and there. So this turkey is about halfway done. I'm gonna go ahead and add spices now, because if you wait till it's done and then you add spices, well, then the meat is just overcooking while you're waiting for the spices to kind of bloom and open up. So I have my measuring cup here, or my measuring spoon, I should say, and I'm going to add 1 tablespoon of chili powder. And you got to watch it with chili powder. Use a good chili powder. But sometimes chili powder can go a little bit salty to the tongue. And sometimes it has a little bit of salt in it, so you want to be careful about that. I'm also going to add 1 teaspoon of the smoked paprika that I mentioned, because it is utterly delicious. And then I'm going to do 1.5 teaspoons of ground cumin. Cumin is really popular when you're making chili or maybe even enchiladas and things like that. It depends. But in taco meat, I think it's needed. It has that great smoky smell that you would kind of expect with Mexican food in general or Tex-Mex food. So put a little bit in there, 1.5 teaspoons. Now just incorporate those spices right into your ground turkey. The onions are turning a little bit translucent as well. You're kind of doing 3 or 4 things here in your pan. You're cooking the meat. The onions cooked for a little while, kind of got started. Then you got your meat cooking down, and about halfway through that, you go in and you add your spices so they can bloom a little bit and open up. Spice is great on its own, but when you put it on heat like this in a pan and you let it cook for a minute, all those flavors tend to open up. The oils in them, even though they're dry, there's still oil in them, will open up, and the bouquet of smell just lights up the whole room. So I'm getting close to the end of finishing up the meat. I'm gonna go ahead and add the 1/2 cup of frozen corn right in there. It's been sitting out for a little bit. If it thaws just a bit, no big deal. Obviously, we're cooking it. As that's working in, go ahead and add your 2 cloves of finely diced garlic. Now, because you're putting some cold stuff in here, if you feel like your simmering process has slowed down a little bit, you can pull the heat up just a couple of notches to keep it going. Now, sometimes cooking down your spices can make them a little too strong. They can almost taste a little too salty, even though we've used very little salt in this. So at this point, I use 1/2 cup of water. I'm just using my measuring cup from the corn. And work that in there a little bit. This will actually kind of help distribute the spices a little better. It'll keep things moist, and as it cooks down, it'll get thicker in a way. It'll actually get a little thicker. Let that simmer just for about 3 or 4 minutes or so. You don't want to go long. You don't want to cook all that water back off of it or anything. You want some of it to disappear by at least half. You may have a little juice in the bottom of your pan, and that's okay. Coming up next in the extra helping, I'm going to show you how to make refried beans. You are never going to buy refried beans in a can again. I'm literally going to show you how to make the best thing you've ever put on a taco. I'll be right back after this.
The most highly decorated female artist of all time, Janet Jackson, Unbreakable. The new album includes the number one hit, No Sleep, featuring J. Cole, the title track, Unbreakable, and Burn It Up, featuring Missy Elliott. Don't miss the Unbreakable World Tour, on sale now. Janet Jackson, Unbreakable, available now on Rhythm Nation BMG, available on iTunes.
In a cast iron skillet, add 1 tablespoon of olive oil. Cook 2 cloves of finely diced garlic for about 15 seconds. Add a 16-ounce can of pinto beans, juice and all. Be sure to get the thicker beans out of the bottom of the can. Over a medium heat, stir the garlic into the beans and let simmer for about 2 minutes. Once all the beans have softened, with a fork, smash every single bean in the pan. This could take a couple of minutes, but continue working the beans around, smashing them and cooking off the bean liquid. The beans will thicken up. When they pull away from the bottom of the skillet, you're getting close. Now add a few dashes of your favorite hot sauce. I'm using a green sauce. Also, add 1 tablespoon of balsamic vinegar. With your fork, incorporate the hot sauce and the vinegar into the beans and continue to cook for about another minute. Make sure it's all blended really well. Remove from the heat and serve, and that's refried beans. As you can see, the ground turkey and the beans are done. The turkey just looks wonderful, and it looks like ground beef. It's dotted with those beautiful yellow pieces of corn. The whole thing's got that great reddish brown tint to it that looks like ground beef, but you know it's healthier for your family. We also have the refried beans, which are just that beautiful pale bean color. Of course, you and I know that there's a little bit of an extra surprise in there with the hot sauce and the balsamic vinegar. I tell you, that will add a great little tang to it, just a little bit underneath, and it will be really authentic tasting. Now, I'm not gonna show you how to make a taco because I know that you know how to make a taco. There's a million ways to do it. There's 1,000 things to put on it. So I'm gonna leave all of that up to you. Me, I'm gonna go have about 6 tacos probably. I love me some tacos, y'all, I really do. Now if you love tacos or you loved any part of this video, click the like button. Be sure to click subscribe so you don't miss any updates coming. Every Friday at 5 p.m. Eastern, there will be a new recipe posted and we have some great stuff in store. And as you've seen, we've already had some really delicious meals. I wanna share them all with you. So for now, go enjoy your tacos. I'm gonna go enjoy mine. Have a great one. Thanks for watching. I'm Ernest. This is Eating in Bed, and I'll see you next time. Bye.